welcome to our scientist very morning now. But before we go any further, we have full turtle safety guideline. So if a pelona make sure ola sa faiuli ma make sure ola sa la sa faile yo before you what before you touch anything else make sure that the germs are free and everything's free everything so thank you I have a bit for this sanitizer na for me faunga what do you use yes found my first simoli and clean water. Laugh with little me there. It's a tawina fight lay only my first simoli. Lale only. Oh, yeah. There. You, if I made loss for say, cone, yeah, before the city had to be a good one or a paper. But quite far away, yeah. Okay, then after that, you dry. Now, before me, I had three cards. So, Lula, your paper, pillay, more. Okay. One. Put on my glasses first. Two. Three. Okay, now, Tolula Pepper Pele, I'm gonna show you what these cards are. Matau Mela Pepper Tapelena, Matau Lima, wow, Matau, Wilola. Okay, they are all red. Okay, now, the same cards, if you're gonna look at it, Toy Matau Mefoila. Pepper Pele, Otsutusa. One, two, three. Otsutusa. Fierce out Pepper Savai. This one? Okay. One, two, three. One of Pepper Tusa. Okay, that's it. Yes, so relax. Put this away.
Looks just like a leaf. But wait, how can a leaf be a rock?
This is a fern fossil. You know how you can tell? Aha! Just as I suspected.
So the leaf just turned into a rock?
Yep. That's how fossils are made.
I thought fossils only came from dinosaurs.
Well, anything can become a fossil. This has to be covered in layers of mud for a very long time.
Anything? Edward, I want to be a fossil.
But you can't. Do you think it will take a long time or a short time for Dawn to become a fossil? Unpause.
Edward? Edward, how long do you think I need to be here to turn into a fossil?
Well, the fossil we found was millions of years old. So you'll be here for a long, long time.
Millions of years? That's a lot of sleeps. What if I have to pee? Oh, Edward, I just don't think I have the patience to be a fossil.
Well, that's good, because I'd rather have a friend than a fossil any day.
What's the word up there? Fossils. All together, fossils. Yeah. Love when you meet all the fossil. What is a fossil? But Elata to guided questions. We have three focus questions. Tolata to Fisila, Elata to La Vumala Papa. Fato in Umfala Tolison, Umfanta to Tarieta Fisila Nato. If you look at this one here, the focus questions here. Question one more. What are fossils? What are fossils? Focus question number two. How are fossils formed? How do they formed? And the last question, question number three, why are fossils important? Why are fossils important? Of course, we can convert these or change these focus questions to learning outcome. You know that usual thing you do in your classroom? Learning outcome. Okay, following outcome, then they will be like this. We are learning to explain what fossils are. That's for learning outcome. We are learning to explain how they are formed, how fossils are formed. See how we converted that to learning outcome. And the last one, we are learning to explain why fossils are important. So we put this on the board, a focus question, okay? So tell me, fossils. Fossils. Would like to share us? So let's have a look at this one. Look at the definition we have here for you. Fossils, okay. We have here. If I tell my screen, fossils are the remains of living things that existed many, 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 many years ago. Okay, that's what fossils are. Okay, read it again. Fossils are the remains of living things that existed many years ago. Or fossils, po meyo toeng o malo. Ah, on mey, po misabi meyola. Ah, sa yaya swala whatever. Pi midiyonga midiyonga tausang. Ah, mamay. Okay, so we put up there. I put up here. Mm-hmm. Get the pictures here of some fossils. That's a fossil here. Look at this one. Or this one. If I've been falling or these are fossils. Being a tall wing of yeah. Ah. Or yeah, swala. Let's put it up here. Fossil come here and we're gonna put you up here. Another picture of fossils. Okay, listen to it here. See the fossil? There comes the fossil. What could be this animal? Could be an animal we had never seen here in Samoa before, right? See, this is good about fossils. Okay. We put them up here. Another one. Let's visit another one. Ah, it's a fossil of a fish. Is that a fish? It's a fossil of a fish. Okay. So, tell me falling on fossil there. Fossil, yeah. Ah. Okay, put it up there. And then, the last one. is it? What is it? Fossil of a what ant? Yeah, leaf. It's a leaf, right? Just imagine. People think I'm all a fossil, name your leaves. Just imagine. But they follow my fossil. Okay, let's put it under here. Well, so now we have, you know what fossils are? Then you can see the examples of fossils here. Let's give you the example of the fossil. Then it comes to the word. What is the word given to the study of fossil? Because that's how you summarize the word. Make sense, huh? At least we understand what fossils are. Because very rare, we're going to use toing or malo throughout our everyday lives. We're going to refer to fossil. Okay, that's a word here. Now, can you say the word? Now, repeat after me. Paleontology. 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 And okay, we put this word up here. Painian. Say it after me. Sitting next to you. You say the word. Repeat after me. Paley. Paley. An. Ta. La. G. Paleontology. Okay, and what is the meaning of this word, paleontology? It is the study of fossils. So we put the definition next to the word. Okay. So if paleontology is the study of fossil, then what are scientists who study fossils called? If a paleontology or studying of fossil or it's a way scientists see a lot of this. Fossils. They like fossils. They go digging for fossils. What are they called? What's the rule that you learned from your English? You what? What was I add an IST to the word? And that word becomes paleontologist. Say the word. Repeat the word after me. Just paleontologist. Again, say it again. Paleontologist. Yeah, of course it's paleontologist. All right, face your sister. Pasanga de lo sister polo kasi ni krongo fo. Okay, now say the word to him. Paleontologist. Make sure it's 1 meter distance, okay? Say the word. Now you two, face the screen. Say the word. Paleontologist. Paleontologist. We put the word up here. Okay, and the meaning. What could be the meaning of that? I have the meaning here, but you guess. If paleontology is the study of fossils, then what is a paleontologist? What does a paleontologist do? Of course, read the definition. It's a scientist who studies the fossilized remains of all kinds of organisms. So the key word here is the name of the scientist. So we put it up here. So let's have a look at these two words here. It's paleontology, study of fossils. Repeat after me. Paleontologist, the scientist who studies the fossil remains, all kinds of organisms, right? Practice saying these words. Practice. Say, paleontology, paleontologist. Right? Okay, like this. Paleontology. Yeah, you got it. Okay, now let's move on. So how are fossils formed? Let's have a look at the second one. How are they formed? So we move on to the second question, focus question, or second outcome, which is finding out how fossils are formed. Now we have here, okay, See, like way, way back, hundreds and millions of years ago, there were animals. Animals, I like that. And this is a swampy area, swampy or watery soil. Let's make the soil watery. The soil is very watery here. Then it dies slowly like this. It's watery. And throughout the years, So every time but the bones remain. Don't forget that. The bones are there. Fossils. That's an example of how fossils are formed. So what did Andy over there? They're coming. Error for your heart. No food. I'm going to die gradually. And then the more dirt, rock, the soil, everything. Bury this one. Yeah. So and just like this one. See how they are formed? And it takes hundreds and thousands and millions of years. See how fossils are formed? Can you explain now how fossils are formed? After this lesson, you can have your own, make your own demonstration of how they are formed. You do this demonstration like this, and then you will understand better how fossils are formed. Okay? Can you now answer the question there? The learning outcome, can you now explain how fossils are formed by that? Okay. Now start, okay? I need to go and wash my hands first. Okay, let's wrap up that question, how fossils are formed. Okay, now fossils are formed in different ways, and most are formed when or what? What's the word there? When a plant or animal dies in a watery environment and is buried in mud and silt. See, do we now know what fossils are formed now? We have done a demonstration, but this is for your own info. Okay, fossils are formed in different ways, but most are formed when a plant or animal dies in a watery environment and is buried in mud and silt. Now let's put this up here. Okay, put it up here. How's that? That's fine. Mow you down here. Wow. Okay, but before we move to the last learning outcome, I've got some resources here with me. Let's make fossils. How's that? Let's make fossils. And what I have here with me, I have here some clay, you know, clay here. And this powder here is called the plaster of bodies. Okay, plaster of Paris. And just for inquiry, where to get this plaster of bodies? You get it from SAP. Okay, very rare. And it is very important in making models. Now we're gonna make a model, a dino fossil. You have your clay here. I'm pretty sure they have clay, right? Clay here. Be careful. And then what we do here is to do this. Your fire is longer. I'm quite long, lovely. They're falling. Long all the way in a minute. Or mangy dinosaur, a young may be with up here. Now pull this out. Pull very gently and very carefully. Wait on me. The shape of it. Okay. So we need this one. We need for a little plasticine there and cover the sides, you know. Oh, plaster of Paris, well, plaster of Paris. Where do you get it from? You get it from Lana at SAP. Okay, you go and ask for that beautiful lady and her companion there. They will show you where to find this plaster. Okay. Get some bit of water. Bit of water. And if I swallow you get if I could go. Yeah, better I'm not quite a fool, yeah. But okay. Yeah. Oh yeah. Okay. Then that's it. Then we leave it to dry. Okay. For mango. We need this to dry. And we go and clean ourselves. We go and clean our hands. Okay. Fruit at all, if I tell you to eat me, we give it 10, 15 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, the fossil song. The early forms of life were soft, their bodies didn't last. But microscopic traces help us learn about the past. 500 million years ago came an important stage. Tough body parts like shells evolved and left us with remains. Fossils, fossils, a special kind of treasure. We dig them up for science and we study them for pleasure. Fossils, fossils from deep within the ground. Despite the plain appearance, they've the power to astound. In case raised in mud for many years, the structure starts to change as over time the animal's soft tissue rots away, and water rich in minerals can seep into the bones, which eventually solidify and turn them into stone. Fossils, fossils, they're hidden in the mud. Creatures that got buried or were caught up in a flood. Fossils, fossils, skeletons and shells. Animals that died and then were buried where they fell. So imagine what's beneath your feet, buried in the dark. Shells, or bones, or teeth, or poo, or a prehistoric shark. Fossils, fossils, it's really rather rare. Remains must be encased without exposure to the air. Fossils, fossils, to die and not decay, before your body's eaten or your bones get blown away. Fossils, fossils, much older than your nan, from half a billion years ago when life on Earth began.
Come off here. Let's see. Dino fossil. Okay, so you can use your the paints from your visual art, you know, tumta apura efetu siata. Found tumta apuna. Melo sevari brown. You can paint it because I don't have paints here, okay? Okay, making our own dino fossil. Yeah, in fact, if I see a shape like this, finger fossil found in here. Nisi me aola po laula a or trick of plants and all that to make your own fossil. The last one is why fossils are important. Why do you think they are important? Maybe we can think, mafofo. Why? Look at this. Look at the development of it, the formation. Why do you think it's the topic on fossils quite interesting? Okay, that's what it says here. It says here, fossils are important because they provide us with the knowledge of animals and plants that lived hundreds of years ago. They also show us that life on Earth was once different from life found on Earth today. Okay, it's quite interesting because dinosaur. Why there were no dinosaurs. But through this they discover perhaps there were animals like this, and they put together these fossils, these bones after their digging. And they came up with this, the construction of this huge animals, tall animals like this, like dinosaurs. Okay, so according to our last focus question, why are these important? Because it tells us the information, gives us the information of what life was back hundreds and thousands and millions of years ago, and also the living organisms that lived in those days. That's a few kilometers laying extinct. So I put this up here. So we put it up here, right? How's that? So have we achieved our questions? Have we able to answer all our focus questions? What fossils are? What fossils are? Fossils are the remains of living things that existed many years ago. Can you now explain what fossils are? Om fanan if I'm a talang is old, then if I'm too talang, I'm a talang fossil. Faye, tell him what fossils are. Yeah, tell him. Okay, and then we come to the next one. How fossils are formed. How are they formed? Your buried, once the animal dies, they are buried layers and layers of soil. And then why fossils are important. Well, tells us what life was back in the animals that lived hundreds and thousands, millions of years ago. But for now, I think time is up, right? I think our time is up. But should, until we meet again, but for now, thank you. Bye.